The Tao Te Ching. Lao Tzu's Timeless Classic for Today. By David Tuffley. 3rd edition, 2019, Altiora Publications. Welcome. There is more meaning packed into the 81 short passages of the Tao Te Ching than other books have in 1,000 pages. Its brevity comes from the simplicity of its expression. As the old saying goes, the greater the truth, the more simply it can be expressed. It is like Doctor Who's TARDIS, much bigger on the inside than it appears from the outside. It is like a time machine in other ways too, its truth is not tied to any particular time. It contains as close to absolute truth in human terms as it is possible to get. Most truths are relative, applying to a cultural context or historical period. But some truths are absolutely true, always have been, always will be, regardless of the culture or time from which it comes. These are the truths contained in the laws of physics and nature. They apply everywhere, all of the time. Follow the advice of the Tao Te Ching and it can be transformational, bringing inner peace, and helping you towards becoming a fuller expression of your human potential. This is so because the Tao Te Ching is essentially a how-to guide for understanding your true nature and how to achieve your full potential. The Tao Te Ching is a guide for creating harmony in yourself and the world around you, by describing a fundamental force called the Tao, that operates uniformly throughout the universe and is the cause of everything that happens. The Tao has been translated as, the way, but it could more accurately be described as, how. The Tao is expressed in the laws of nature, and the laws of physics. The Tao Te Ching shows you how to develop personal power, through cultivating alignment with the Tao, otherwise known as going with the flow, in popular culture. A central idea in the Tao Te Ching is the importance of avoiding extremes, and keeping to the moderate middle path as you go through life. Find the middle ground between the extremes in any situation, thus avoiding counter-reactions and unintended consequences. The result is neutrality and stability. Harmony with the Tao is living so that the events of our life do not turn into personal dramas. The problem with drama is that it sets up a pendulum-like swing, from one drama to the next, which gets in the way of calm inner reflection and clear perception of reality. But people quite enjoy their dramas. It might even be true to say that they are addicted to them, it can be how people define themselves. The Tao Te Ching encourages us to sense the world around us directly, and to contemplate our impressions deeply from a position of neutrality. It advises against relying on the structures of orthodox belief that have been created by others. Such ideologies remove us from a direct experience of life in the now, and cut us off from our intuition. Following the middle path requires you to develop an awareness of the unseen physical forces that direct the events taking place around you. Such forces operate at the levels of macrocosm and microcosm. You could think of them as operating in the universe as a whole, and in the minds and lives of individuals. Mental alignment with these forces gives you the power to influence events in the world without resorting to force. That is the way of the Tao. Subtle influence is better than force. The Tao Te Ching suggests using subtle influence, not force, to achieve your goals. The objective is to avoid taking action that elicits strong counter-reactions that are a distraction, and which consume time and energy to manage. In nature, we see that excessive force in one direction triggers the growth of a neutralizing force. It has the effect of returning the system to a stable state. This principle is seen in human affairs too. Force cannot be the basis for establishing a sustainable social environment. Accepting the inevitability of change. When you come to know the Tao, you understand that everything in the universe is in a state of dynamic change. Nothing, absolutely nothing that exists is permanent. Everything passes into non-existence when its time comes. When you know this, you become less attached to the transitory things of this world. You can still enjoy and value these while they last, but when they leave you, your suffering will be lessened. The forces of change are largely beyond your control. It is not easy for people to accept the inevitable passing of that which we care about, but it can be done. Accepting the reality of impermanence aligns our thinking with those forces that bring about gradual change in the social and physical world. We learn to embrace change and not mind when it happens. One spiritual teacher from another discipline was asked what the secret was to being enlightened. The master replied, "I simply do not mind what happens." Becoming a force of nature. Our alignment with the forces underpinning nature makes us an integral part of the evolving world. It confers upon us the momentum of those larger forces. You become that metaphorical swimmer, calmly going with the current in the great river of life while all around you other swimmers flail this way and that. Our perceptions become more finely tuned because they are based on the reality of the present moment. We see the world as it is, not as we want it to be or believe it should be. A handbook for people of influence. The Tao Te Ching is a response to a time of political unrest. China in that period had been comprised of a patchwork of states frequently in conflict. The Tao Te Ching is a leadership manual written to educate people of influence how to establish peace and prosperity in the land. The Tao Te Ching is the result of Lao Tzu's careful observations of the unfolding patterns of nature. From these, a set of underlying principles were deduced, principles that cause the world to behave in the way it does. These principles are abstract in the way that a mathematical formula is an abstraction. Knowledge of these principles is tremendously helpful for a person seeking harmony and balance, just as the mathematical formula pi r squared is helpful for calculating the area of a circle, any circle at any scale. The interconnectedness of all things. Lao Tzu discerned not only the dynamically changing nature of the world. He also saw that the 10,000 things are interconnected to form one hugely diverse system that is held together and given shape by a single unifying force, the Tao. The abstraction of the Tao is difficult to express in purely logical terms, so the author resorted to paradox in much the same way as Zen koans do. This induces an intuitive understanding that complements logical awareness. Polarity and the Big Bang. An important principle in this unifying field of forces is polarity. Lao Tzu's understanding of how the universe began matches closely what we today would recognize as the Big Bang. Before the Bang, there was the Supreme Absolute which had limitless undifferentiated potential but no physical existence. Then, in the instant of the Bang, the Supreme Absolute divided itself from non-existence in an event that created space and time, and which is characterized by ongoing phenomena determined by cause and effect. This physical universe is founded upon two charged states, yin, negative, and yang, positive. Due to the complementary polarity of matter and energy, these constantly pull apart and regroup to create the changing, evolving physical reality that is the universe we know. Everything in the phenomenal universe comes into existence through the dynamically interacting polarities of yin and yang. The way that yin and yang interact is governed by the laws of physics, which Lao Tzu called the Tao. Thus, we can view the Tao as an indication of the larger purpose of the Supreme Absolute. Being proactive, not reactive. The wise look for the seeds of change, those underlying triggers that point to what is likely to happen in the future. It is useful to know that everything in the physical world will, in time, be transformed into its own opposite. Birth to death, happy to sad, strong to weak, day to night. There are countless examples. This is the manifestation of polarity. Observing this can give you penetrating insight into the direction of worldly affairs. When you know this, you can proactively use this insight to position yourself favorably for when the future arrives. For example, when we look at European history from the year 1000 to 2000, we see a pattern of aggregation. Beginning with many smaller states in the 11th century, there has emerged a unified Europe 1000 years later in the 21st century. During that time, there have been recurring cycles of war and peace, ignorance and enlightenment, plague and prosperity. We see that the smaller states have aggregated to become larger and larger states. For example, the unification of the German states under Bismarck in the 19th century and again in 1990 with the reunification of East and West Germany into a single federated state. This movement of the Tao has evolved Europe into a single economic entity in the form of the European Union. In the 21st century, this unification process is extending east and south to the Islamic world and the shores of Africa, areas not previously thought of as European. Given this trend towards unification, it might reasonably be predicted that the European Union will continue to incorporate non-EU states until it becomes necessary to change the name European, or at least redefine what Europe means. Meanwhile, the always independently minded Britain, from their position as an offshore island, has opted to exit from the Union, while attempting to maintain friendly trade relations. Another example is the rise and fall of political and commercial empires. History has many examples of empires that began modestly, rose to great power, then declined when their power spent itself. The Roman, the Ottoman, and the British empires are examples of political and mercantile empires backed up by military force. The Dutch East India Company and the British East India Company are early examples of powerful trading empires that have since disintegrated. If we understand how the Tao influences patterns of behavior, at both the individual and collective levels, we are well positioned to influence the course of worldly events. we can extrapolate those perceived patterns forwards into the future, and use them to guide our actions in the present. We can engineer the future by performing the necessary actions now. Albert Einstein and the Tao Te Ching. Einstein is surely one of the most influential thinkers of the modern era. His paradigm-shifting ideas changed the face of physics and the course of history in the nuclear age, ideas that still resonate powerfully a century later. While Einstein did not identify as a Taoist, his work manifests many of the ideas contained in the Tao Te Ching. Einstein expresses them in strikingly similar terms. Thus, there are parallels with the work of Lao Tzu, both of whom had a consuming passion to understand the laws of nature, the laws of physics, and to know what invisible but all-powerful informing principles make the universe behave as it does. The 81 passages of the Tao Te Ching. Passage 1, the ineffable Tao. The Tao that can be spoken, is not the real Tao. The Tao is ineffable, impossible to express. The principle at the heart, of every created thing. In the absence of desire, the Tao reveals its nature. In the presence of desire, see only the physical, no deeper. Commentary, the word Tao is merely a word that points to the deeper reality. That reality is not of this physical world, so it cannot be truly described by words which are themselves quite arbitrary. The Tao is an abstract principle that informs the structure of all physical forms. When an acorn germinates, it is the Tao that instructs the seedling how to become an oak tree that lives for centuries. The Tao is the informing principle contained in the acorn. Science calls it DNA. Another way to think about this is that the Tao is the laws of nature. No one can see the laws, but we do see how the laws give shape to the world and everything in it. In the absence of desire, the Tao reveals itself to the intuitive mind. Passage 2, the swinging pendulum of polarity. When the world recognizes beauty, it is on the way to being ugly. When the world recognizes virtue, it is on the way to being vicious. Whenever fullness approaches, the opposite now comes. Thus, the sage acts with effortless grace, in harmony with the flow. Actions speak louder than words. Nourishing without possessing, the people prosper. Commentary, polarity is the operating principles that underlies all phenomena in the physical world, life and death, beauty and ugliness, good and evil, long and short, easy and hard, high and low, sound and silence, sickness and health, richer and poorer, night and day, everything. Everything is in constant motion from one state of being to its opposite. The wise observe this world of polarity with detachment and tries to harmonize with the movement, seeking where they can to moderate the amplitude of the swing. In this way, they behave like the Tao. Passage 3, scarcity creates competition. The struggle to be first. The pursuit of money. Titles and honors. It is a fool's errand. Therefore, do not make some things valuable and some people champions. Winners mean losers and paupers. Encourage all to reach their potential. Value each contribution to the greater good. Commentary, the problem with ranking people on a league table of achievement is that for every winner there are multiple losers. It is a practice that creates resentment and tends to demotivate the non-winners. The belief is that the losers will be motivated to try harder, but for every loser that tries to be a champion, there will be three or more who decide to stop trying and opt out of the game. Yet those same people have the potential to contribute something valuable which goes to waste in a competitive environment.
Passage 4, the nature of the Tao. The Tao is the origin and cause of all that exists, and all that will ever exist. Entirely without limit, it has always existed. The Tao creates and destroys in equal measure over time, blunting the sharp, untangling the knotted, softening the hard. Everything. It even created the gods. Commentary, the Tao is analogous to the laws of nature. Such laws are abstractions without physical form. But their influence is seen everywhere in the physical world. The Tao is not touchable, but it is observable. For example, the formula pi r squared, the mathematical rule for calculating the area of a circle, where pi equals 22 divided by 7. An absolute truth, this rule can be applied to any circle, anywhere, anytime, at any scale from an atom up to a spiral galaxy and beyond. The Tao is the agent by which all physical forms evolve, the pervasive influence that evolves forms into their opposite and back again in ongoing cycles.
Passage 5, Sameness of Bearing. The Tao is impartial. All is treated equally. The wise are impartial. They too treat equally. Favoring none. Disparaging none. Heedless of status. Independent of mind. Be not distracted. Focus on the Tao.
Commentary: the Tao is completely impartial.
No special treatment is shown to anyone or anything. The sun shines on the sinner and the saint alike. The equivalent in human terms is sameness of bearing, the treating of everyone equally, regardless of rank or status.
Sameness of bearing creates emotional and intellectual independence from the world, enabling one's intuition to expand and strengthen. The world is perceived directly without distortions introduced by wishful thinking. Independence tunes one's sensibilities to the subtle ways of the Tao.
Passage 6, Alignment with the Subtle. The Tao is the spirit of place. That abides eternally. On the mountain tops. And in the valleys. Over the hills. And far away.
Mother Nature.
Creator of all things. Know the Mother. Abide in her bosom. You cannot fail.
Commentary: the Tao is the informing principle that permeates all of nature, from big to small, everywhere, all of the time. The wise work to bring awareness of the Tao into their consciousness, allowing it to permeate their thinking and guide their actions. Avoiding force, the wise know of the counter-reactions and take care to avoid such reactions. They know that cause and effect rule the physical world, so they set up the right causes to produce the desired effects. Awareness of these causal links is never far away.
Having created the right conditions, they wait patiently for events to run their course. Others say, "You are so lucky," but the wise know they have made their own luck.
Passage 7, Selflessness. The Tao is immortal and eternal, immortal because it is never born, and because it will never die. The Tao is the creative force, driving the birth of all things. The wise act by not acting. Action comes eventually, seeming fluid and natural. No resistance in the beginning. Put yourself outside and below, social forces bring you to the center. Commentary: periods of action are naturally followed by inaction. To create a situation in which action is required, the wise begins with inaction to prepare the way. The transition from inaction to action then seems natural, effortless. Barely noticed, it is unlikely to be opposed. By placing themselves last and outside, a situation is created where the natural social forces inherent in a system will compel them towards the center. Passage 8, Being Non-Competitive. Water is a role model. It seeks not the high places. Instead the low. The uninviting places. Wherever it rests. Water brings benefit. The sage behaves like water. And seeks not the high places. The sage speaks no ill. And is truthful to all. The sage goes not to war. No blame attaches to that. Commentary: it is the nature of water to seek the low places where it abides and brings benefit. The wise emulate this pattern and seek out the places where the proud disdain to go. They care little for status, fancy titles, or even for the opinions of the people who value those empty symbols. The conventional wisdom that holds sway in the West champions the competitive struggle for supremacy. Life is an endless struggle to get more as you race to the top. You may have to stab a few competitors along the way, climb over their bodies. The wise cultivate a win-win mindset. Passage 9, Dwelling not in fullness. That which is full today must soon start to empty. Stop before reaching the peak. It is all downhill from there. That which is sharp becomes blunt. The treasure trove is soon plundered. And vaulting pride destined for a fall. Dwell not in fullness. Emulate the Tao. Commentary: when reaching one's objectives, when developing a situation to its fullest potential, thus achieving great success, it is tempting to rest on one's laurels in that exalted position and enjoy the fruits of success and perhaps the good opinion of others. But the wise know that whenever a situation reaches its full potential, it is destined to decline soon after. The wise do not linger on the mountain top but descend immediately into the valley before starting to climb the next mountain.
Passage 10, Harmony Within. Awareness of the Tao brings harmony within. Have no fixed ideas, no clever schemes, low expectations, harmony within. Take no action and all things come to pass.
Commentary: all the experiences we have are a direct reflection of our inner state.
If we are to dwell in awareness of the Tao, we must moderate the polarity of our inner world to a steady state.
Only then can we go deeper to know our true nature beyond ego and worldly definitions. Act without ulterior motive, keep expectations low, and advance plans indirectly from behind the scenes.
The less obvious you are, the less opposition you encounter.
Passage 11, using what is not there.
A wheel revolves around its hub. The emptiness makes it useful. The empty space within a glass gives the glass its function. The emptiness of windows and doors are the reason they exist. The sage works to create a condition of emptiness that nature must fulfill, like air rushing into a vacuum.
Commentary: emptiness endures only long enough for nature to put something in it or pass something through it. Everywhere in the world are objects whose emptiness is what gives them their utility.
Windows and doors, the space enclosed by the room itself, are only useful for what they do not contain.
The wise use this principle to evolve situations in desirable ways by creating a perceived need, then waiting for nature to fill the need.
Passage 12, limiting sensual desire.
The sights, the sounds,
the flavors of the world, these earthly delights obscure the Tao, distract the mind, and create desire. The sage limits desire, becomes free of addiction. Simplicity and lack of desire is how to know the Tao.
Commentary: the pleasures of the flesh, or of any worldly thing, produces happiness for a short time only.
The joy soon passes, and what remains is addiction for more.
These are distractions that prevent people from coming to a deeper awareness of the Tao as it embodied in them. Since most are unaware of the Tao, their opinions should not be allowed to influence your character development. These misinformed individuals might be discouraging good behavior and encouraging bad.
Passage 13, Transcending Ego. Praise and disgrace, two sides of the same coin. The ego struts and frets its hour upon the stage, invested in people's opinions. The ego is the self is ego, or so we think. Go now beyond the ego, embrace the whole world. Transcend the ego, and become the whole world. The embodiment of the Tao. Commentary: praise and ridicule are the principal ways that society enforces its behavioral standards. The not very subtle message is, conform to groupthink, or we will reject you. If you do conform, we will accept you, maybe even praise you now and again. Praise and ridicule are the currency by which our conformity with group norms is purchased. This kind of thinking keeps us firmly confined within the narrow boundaries of our ego. This passage advocates transcending the ego, stepping out of the conditioned thinking and identify with the whole world. You are the microcosm, the world is the macrocosm. Both are qualitatively similar expressions of the Tao. Passage 14, The Essence. What we cannot see, we call invisible. What we cannot hear, we call inaudible. What we cannot touch, we call intangible. Together we call them inscrutable. The inscrutable is the void of non-being. The inscrutable is the Tao. The many sights, sounds and tastes of lived experience are not the Tao. Know the Tao by observing the world. Let Mother Nature be your teacher. She is the Tao made manifest. Commentary: the Tao is formless, nameless and intangible. It can only be properly apprehended by the intuitive mind. The analytic mind can study physics and know something of the Tao that way. But these insights are not the reality of the Tao, not revealed by analysis alone. We must integrate the intuitive and analytic parts of our brain, the functions of the left and right hemispheres. When using our whole brain, we combine the superb pattern matching abilities of the left side with the creativity and intuition of the right side. We create an unbeatable team. Passage 15, Subtle Influence. The Tao confers a subtle power on those who come to know it. Careful like walking on thin ice. Impartial like a match referee. Respectful like a humble guest. Honest like a trusted teacher. welcoming like a generous host. When you emulate these qualities and perceive the simple truth, you shall be renewed every day. Commentary: compared to the overtly direct methods used in the West to get things done, the Tao operates in an altogether more subtle, even mysterious way. Being subtle, people easily overlook it, and so it attracts no attention, much less opposition. If one is to exercise subtle influence, it is necessary to come into a harmonious awareness of the inherent unity and simplicity of the world that lies beyond and beneath the world of appearances. This is the subtle power of the Tao.
Passage 16, The Eternal Tao.
The wise seek to know the Tao. Begin by calming the mind. Look without judgment or thought.
Notice how all things arise, exist, then return to stillness, the source.
It has always been thus. Knowing this is deep insight, not knowing is unfortunate.
Meditate long on this great truth, your heart will open like a flower.
Open heart lead to noble action. Noble action lead to the divine. Perceive then the Tao, become one with it, and become eternal.
Commentary: come to know the Tao by silencing the mental chatter and allowing the intuitive mind to quietly observe the unfolding patterns of life.
It is the Tao that gives shape and form to these patterns. Apprehend the patterns through intuition.
Not to do this is to remain ignorant, and ignorance is a most unfortunate state of affairs.
Passage 17, The Essence of Leadership. The best leader is barely known. The next best is known and loved. Then comes the one who is respected. Finally, the despised and ridiculed one. Trust is the key. Good leaders trust and are trusted. And when the job is finished, the team says, "We did it ourselves." Commentary: good leaders invest trust in those they lead. By trusting, so they are trusted.
A bond is forged.
People feel in control, autonomous.
The conditions are right for the work to be done without undue influence from the leader. Bad leaders micromanage their team, stripping them of their initiative and their ability to act autonomously.
All of which is perceived as a lack of trust. Resentment inevitably follows.
Passage 18, Instincts and Intuition.
When the Tao declines, human virtue is born. Knowledge and intelligence. Their dark side, hypocrisy. Mandating family harmony. Creates rules for filial piety. When the country is in chaos, loyal citizens proclaim themselves. And the disloyal must be rooted out.
Commentary: when the Tao is absent from people's lives, they lack a moral foundation. Society responds to the lack with rules about moral conduct.
But people don't like such rules. They look for ways around them. When there is trouble in the family, filial piety is demanded.
When a country is torn by internal strife, patriotism is born.
In the Taoist view, instinct and intuition are the trusted foundation for moral conduct.
But when instinct is lost, codified standards of right behavior are instituted, but these are not as effective as the Tao.
Passage 19, Simplicity of the Tao. Orthodox beliefs and conventional wisdom are straitjackets for the mind. Abandon the conventional, pursue not the clever strategies. Return to the simplicity of nature, the people will return to goodness. Seek purity, embrace simplicity, forego self-interest, limit desires, return to natural love and the simplicity of the Tao. Commentary: social conventions and right thinking are an attempt to create social cohesion. Yet often this only prevents the social environment from evolving. Likewise, clever strategies create a social condition lacking in trust. Returning to simplicity has the opposite effect of creating a naturally cooperative society in which goodwill towards the many is the norm. Passage 20, The Independent Mind. I have no fixed ideas. My mind is open. I follow not the crowd. I know the world by experiencing the world, not by the group mind. That is why I stand alone, remote but independent. Commentary: listening to the wisdom of the crowd is misleading when the crowd is misinformed. As one sage put it, I do not recognize the collective wisdom of the individually ignorant. Far better to have intellectual independence and to think for yourself. But it takes courage to step out of the crowd. Perception of reality requires one to have an independence of thought, a rare phenomenon. It makes you an outsider, shunned and ridiculed by the group-thinking devotees of the orthodoxy. After all, you threaten their beliefs, they instinctively want to neutralize you. So, keep apart from them and do not let them know what you are thinking. It is enough that you yourself know. At least now you are free to think without interference. Passage 21, you do not have life, you are life. The highest virtue is to know the Tao. To the undisciplined mind. The Tao is elusive. The Tao has no taste. Cannot see the Tao directly. The Tao makes no sound. To most, the Tao does not exist. Yet it is the cause of all existence. Commentary, all life on this planet is an expression of the Tao, the informing principle that underlies all life. The appearance of separateness is an illusion. They are not separate lives, but instances of the one life made manifest in all their myriad forms. People speak of my life as though it is something that belongs to them, something they possess. As tempting as it is to think this, the appearance of ownership is an illusion. We are simply embodiments of the Tao, spiritual beings having a physical experience.
Passage 22, knowing the pattern.
Curves become straight, deep becomes shallow, empty becomes full, the patterns of nature made manifest. The wise avoid extremes, neither straight nor curved, deep nor shallow, empty nor full.
They go unnoticed because they are moderate.
Their universal awareness gives them personal power. Commentary, events are governed by the law of cause and effect, the bigger the cause, the bigger the effect. The wise transcend the cycles of cause and effect by coming into harmonious balance with their environment. Because they create little or no cause, there is little or no effect.
Their existence has not disturbed the natural balance, so they are free to observe unhindered. Likewise, they avoid the trappings of wealth and worldly power as being empty status symbols.
Instead, they cultivate inner awareness, informed by the Tao.
Passage 23, the steady force of nature. The harmony of nature
is rarely disturbed.
The violent storm soon passes. Most days are calm and peaceful. Change happens slowly.
Barely noticed.
Because it is harmonious.
The wise move towards their goals.
With practiced ease. Their life more like a sunny day. Than a tempest. The steady force of attitude prevails.
Commentary. Violent extremes are self-defeating, their excessive force creates a neutralizing counter-reaction. Nature normally operates in a steady, harmonious way that brings gradual change.
Violent events like hurricanes and earthquakes are exceptions that prove the rule that most of the time nature is benign.
In human affairs, the wise know that violent confrontations bring unfortunate consequences, so they avoid such confrontation. Lasting change comes from sustained effort, so the wise avoid aggressive moves.
They favor the low-key approach that draws little resistance. Unopposed, they get things done. Passage 24, avoiding self-aggrandizement. Overreaching creates vulnerability.
Like a person standing on tiptoe.
Exertion leads to exhaustion. Difficult to keep up the pace. The wise do nothing to extremes. Make no self-righteous show. The people do not condemn. Go gently on your journey in life. Trusting the Tao as you go.
Commentary, there is a leveling mechanism in group psychology that balances the excesses of self-aggrandizing people who create instability in the social dynamic. Therefore, the wise avoid being too visible or boastful.
The wise avoid hypocrisy and any appearance of it.
As tempting as it might be to agree with people in private discussions, then express a different opinion with other people, the wise avoid this in order to maintain their integrity and generate trust. Such behavior may not please everyone, and you may be criticized for it, but it does earn a reputation for impartiality if not integrity.
This practice brings long-term benefits.
Any benefit gained through hypocrisy is short-lived when the friend of today becomes an enemy tomorrow.
Integrity earns the respect of all, if not their friendship.
Passage 25, the origin of all. In a tremendous desire to know itself, the Tao created heaven and earth. This we call the Big Bang. The power behind the Bang, it is beyond naming, it is the great mystery, the source of all creation, and all destruction, too. In a constant state of flux, flowing this way and that. Carried away by the flow, brought back by the flow, like driftwood on the tide. Such are the cycles of nature. Know the mother, honor her. Commentary: The Big Bang was the consequence of the Tao's tremendous desire to experience itself in the physical sense. In the billions of years since, and in the billions yet to come, the Tao brings physical forms into existence where they endure and experience for a time, then return to non-existence in endless transformative cycles. The poet T.S. Eliot illustrates this in his poem Little Gidding: We shall never cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started, and know the place for the first time. Passage 26, The Source of Mastery. A calm center gives the leader gravity. Remaining calm. No emotion displayed. Even in the turmoil. They can be trusted. Great with power. The calm foundation is the source of mastery. Commentary: Wise leaders present themselves as sober and calm so that they might stay focused on what is important and not be distracted by less important matters. In politics, when adversaries exert influence, the calm center of the enlightened leader absorbs their efforts and neutralizes those efforts. All the while exercising careful judgment. This sober and judicious leader can be trusted with great power and to not use it unwisely. Most of the time that power is used as a deterrent, and only rarely as a weapon. When it is used with visible reluctance. Passage 27, Avoiding Manipulation. When taking action, cause nothing unintended. When walking through the forest, leave no tracks. When speaking, give no offense. Simplicity is harder than it looks. Cultivate the big picture. Keep intentions benevolent. The gossipers will not find fault. The simplicity of the Tao endows gravity to one's character. Commentary: Clever schemes and coercion have a way of producing the opposite of what was intended, earning the schemer a reputation for cunning. The wise know it is better to act with simple honesty in pursuit of one's goals, thus generating trust. This kind of simplicity is achieved through spontaneous, intuitive action based on an understanding of human nature. This is the opposite of a Machiavellian deception that may succeed in the short term but be recognized for what it is in the mid to long term.
Passage 28, The Power of Collective Effort.
The wise leader emulates the forces that bind the universe, applies them to the people, and so unite the many into a common cause.
The wise leader is a lake, with its many tributaries. But they are not the lake, they are the vessel that contains the lake. Barely noticed, but essential.
Commentary: Wise leaders emulate the Tao by applying to the social environment the same laws of nature that operate the physical world. With subtlety they create an environment in which the collective efforts of the many can be woven together, all under the barely noticed influence of the wise leader who all the while maintains a humble posture.
The people feel the work is their own and work harder because of that. Passage 29, Harmony.
The subtle complexity of the universe.
So far beyond human comprehension. The wise appreciate its perfection. Marvel at it but leave it be. Tampering will make it unravel. Like the cutting of a clumsy surgeon. Harmony with the Tao is avoidance of extremes. Being moderate. Commentary: There is an inner consistency and harmony in nature.
Cells replicate, crystals grow, flowers bloom, civilizations rise and fall, whole galaxies revolve and gyrate, their behavior is programmed in.
They always act according to their natures.
Do not tamper with these natural processes.
Doing so usually creates more problems than you had before.
In social systems, the wise person positions themselves so as to be in harmony with the evolutionary forces operating in that environment. The wise refrain from acting when it would adversely affect the natural evolutionary flow.
Passage 30, Avoiding Aggression. When advising the powerful, avoid the advocation of force. Use only when unavoidable, lest it rebound and do harm.
Armies leave scorched earth.
For years, nothing will grow. Be mindful of cause and effect.
Know that pride is destructive.
And avoid an excess of anything.
Commentary: Aggression in all its forms should be avoided, because it creates excess, and excess causes counter-reactions.
Where decisive action is called for, behave assertively, not crossing over into aggression.
Assertion is restrained action that respects everyone's rights, including your own. Aggression in individuals and groups consumes energy and resources, which leads to resource depletion.
Restrained action uses that energy constructively in the pursuit of its goals. The wise know that success does not have to come at someone else's expense.
The wise seek out the win-win scenario where everyone benefits.
Passage 31, Using Force as Last Resort. Weapons are made for killing, use only in extreme need. Warmongers glorify weapons, display and rattle and threaten. The wise use only as last resort, only then and with a cool head and profound regret. Display no pleasure in killing, no gloating in victory, the dead on both sides must be honored. Commentary, when circumstances make it unavoidable, the rare use of force is sanctioned. The wise leader expresses regret at having to use force. As in nature, the occasions when overwhelming force is apparent are relatively rare, like when extreme weather events strike. Most of the time, nature is moderate as it brings about slow, evolutionary change in the environment. The wise leader emulates this. Passage 32, Avoiding Specialization. The Tao is beyond reason. It cannot be defined. We know it by its effects. The cause remains a mystery. Harnessing the Tao is power. Harmony in the ruler's domain. With all things becoming possible. But curiosity leads to analysis paralysis. The world becomes more complicated. Cannot stop at analyzing one thing. We must analyze further and more. One thing becomes two things. Two things become four. Four things become eight. Exponential growth. Where do we stop? Nobody knows. But the Tao knows. Many becomes one. Commentary, there are proper limits to specialization lest it continues ad infinitum. People lose the big picture, become lost and disoriented by the detail. Passage 33, Know thyself, master thyself. Know thyself. Master thyself. All else follows from these. Power over others. Is the illusion of control. Know how much is enough. And you will be wealthy. Be constant in your efforts. And all things can be done. Commentary, the wise put their main effort into self-mastery, that is coming to understand their nature. The less wise seek mastery over others, to gain power. But this has a limited lifespan. Cunning schemes are soon replaced by even more cunning schemes. Those who have attained mastery of self are able to exercise a subtle influence over worldly affairs. Their legacy endures because it is in tune with the Tao. They influence events while a situation is in its formative stage.
Passage 34, An Evolutionary Force.
As swimmers in the river of life, we are all immersed in the Tao. As a servant it sustains us, when something is old, it returns to the Tao. When something is young, it emerges from the Tao.
Sustaining all, destroying all, the Tao takes no credit, it is the informing principle. Commentary, Lao Tzu was a physicist for his times.
But his words come from a different culture and mindset.
The way Lao Tzu expressed himself does not much resemble the language of modern physics, but still there is common ground. The Tao is described as the driving force, the informing principle that has guided the evolution of the world for eons. Learn to see the interconnectedness of all things around us, thus bringing our microcosm into alignment with the greater macrocosm.
Passage 35, Contemplating the Subtle. Those who know the Tao may safely guide the world. Staying upon the middle path, peace and prosperity prevail. But such leaders are rare, since abiding by the Tao brings no worldly pleasure, even though knowing the Tao brings limitless blessings.
Commentary, those who consciously embody the Tao are well suited for leadership but are seen only rarely. These are the philosopher kings of old. They are wise leaders who act out of altruism, not personal power.
They practice moderation and do nothing to extremes. Their subtle wisdom naturally attracts people. It is their inherent gravitas and deep inner peace that attracts people.
A subtle attraction, unlike that of the pleasures of going to parties and indulging in the pleasures of the flesh. One finds it difficult to say why the Tao is attractive. It operates beyond the level of worldly interpretation.
Passage 36, soft is stronger than hard. That which is small must once have been big. That which succeeds must first have failed. That which is strong must once have been weak. That which has been demoted must first have been promoted. Before you receive, you must first have given.
This is the natural order.
That is how soft and weak overcomes hard and strong. Commentary: the movement of the Tao is cyclic.
Recognize this movement of opposites and try to moderate the amplitude of the pendulum swing down to a minimum, preferably to a steady state.
You can now see the action of the Tao, unobscured by the reactions and consequences of earlier ill-advised actions.
Passage 37, guiding rather than ruling. The Tao appears motionless, yet through inaction, all things come to pass. The leader who knows this, their strategy is non-action. It takes away desire, and brings stability, to the people they lead. Commentary: people inherently dislike coercive force. The normal consequence is to resist and subvert these heavy-handed methods. Their instinct is for freedom to think and act as they see fit. Even when the wise leader has the authority to order people about, they avoid doing so. True leadership is getting people to want to do what you want them to do because they want to do it. Passage 38, influencing without motive. True virtue is unconscious of its own virtuous nature. Outward show of virtue is not the true virtue. True virtue is spontaneous, without action or motive, with kindness and justice. But where the Tao is absent, outward shows of virtue become the order of society. Commentary: true virtue does not draw attention to itself. Obvious shows of virtue such as showy philanthropy is therefore not true virtue. Goodness cannot be forced into the open, it must arise spontaneously in its own time. When you operate like this, much is achieved with little effort. When actions arise from cunning, though there is much to do, still there is much left undone. When the Tao is absent, society creates codes of conduct, standards of behavior. And when that behavior is breached, codes of justice become necessary. And when justice is forgotten, society resorts to empty ritual to give the appearance of order. When the Tao is absent, we see behavior that is empty of meaning. Therefore, the sage dwells in the subtlety of the Tao and forsakes outward shows of virtue. Passage 39, cultivating oneness. Since the beginning of time, all things are created by the Tao. In the absence of the Tao, nothing can exist. The wise leader embodies the Tao, humbly serving the greater good, bringing stability and prosperity. No strutting like a rooster, no shows of power, and no shows of virtue either. These will bring them undone. Commentary: the wise leader knows that the Tao is the underlying cause of everything in the world, so they emulate the Tao by leading with humility and simplicity, which are the essential qualities of the Tao. In this way they bring stability and harmony to the society of those they lead. Being puffed up and vainglorious is a sure way to destabilize one's leadership. People despise and ridicule this kind of leader.
Passage 40, two sides of the same coin.
The great Tao moves in cycles, name one thing that does not. Endless cycles of creation and destruction, at one time creating, another time destroying.
Creation is not more virtuous than destruction. Two sides of the same coin, both are necessary in equal measure. Commentary: creation is applauded by many and destruction is lamented.
But the wise take the view that the cycle of creation and destruction is necessary to maintain proper balance in the world. From the perspective of the Tao, creation is not more virtuous than destruction because they need each other in equal measure.
Too much of one and not enough of the other leads to imbalance. Unlimited growth is as problematic as unlimited destruction. Passage 41, strength in weakness. When the wise hear of the Tao, they practice it diligently.
When the average person hears,
they think about it now and again. When the fool hears of the Tao, they scoff and laugh derisively.
That is how we recognize the Tao.
Its subtlety seems contradictory. Advancing looks like retreat. The easy way seems hard. The greatest virtue seems to have no value.
Know that strength resides
in apparent weakness.
Commentary: how does one describe the invisible cause of the whole universe?
We call it the Tao, the way, for want of a better name. We might also call it how. Consider the metaphor of a majestic river in which all creatures swim. The movement of the Tao can be seen at many levels. There is the flow of life from one day to the next. The flow of history measured in centuries.
And the flow of evolution itself, measured in millions of years. Seek detachment by concentrating on the cause of the flow, not on the surface phenomena.
Passage 42, Polarity. In the moment when time began, zero became one, and one became two, doubling and redoubling. As the universe expanded, objects exist for a time, then return to the Tao.
Endless cycles of
creation and destruction. Live simply, with few possessions. Become wealthy, being like the Tao. Commentary: before the Big Bang, there was nothing. The pre-bang state was zero. There was only limitless potential. In the moment of the bang, the physical universe came into existence through the desire of the Tao to know itself in the physical sense. The physical universe became subject to polarity from that moment.
In the billions of years since, the universe has been multiplying itself, perhaps exponentially. The Tao operates through polarity as seen in the law of cause and effect.
Actions have equal and opposite reactions.
In human affairs, this manifests as cycles of good and bad, day and night, war and peace, economic boom and bust, ignorance and enlightenment, love and hate, easy and hard. Millions of pairs without end.
Passage 43, Subtle Influence. Like water over river stones, that which is soft wears down the hard. The softest thing in the world overcomes the hardest thing. That which is hard is already becoming soft, and the soft becoming hard. With strategic non-action, all things can be achieved. Patience is more than a virtue, it is the virtue. Commentary: Lao Tzu observed that many of the troubles of the world are reactions to earlier provocations. Reactive people in the world are inclined towards taking revenge against those who do them harm, regardless of who started it. Feuds can go on for generations. The principle at work here is what you resist persists. Refrain from action, the trouble is ebbs away and does not come back. Use subtle influence and minimal action to solve problems. Passage 44, Knowing how much is enough. A good life need not be about wealth and status. Attachments are an anchor around your neck. When seeking the Tao, know how much is enough, and you will know peace. Commentary: attachments to people and material things keeps one's thinking rooted in the material mindset. Attachment inhibits the development of heightened awareness of the free-flowing Tao in everyday life. In this mindset, objects are fixed, they do not flow freely. The wise free themselves from the burden of too many possessions and so travel unhindered, without debt obligations and worries about their wealth or reputation. Freedom from unnecessary attachments allows the freedom to move along with the great flow of the Tao. Passage 45, Avoiding Full Maturity. Great deeds appear small. Yet somehow, they suffice. Boundless fullness appears empty. The truth appears as lies. Great skill appears clumsy. Great orders appear tongue-tied. Avoid full maturity. It is already declining. Commentary: even the greatest accomplishments will one day be reduced to naught by the endless cycles of creation and destruction to which all things are subject. Great wealth spent, great deeds forgotten. In the grand scheme, what is great becomes small, what is small becomes great. The problem with knowing this is the time frame is uncomfortably long for human comprehension. Appearances can be deceiving. Great intelligence can seem foolish. Great eloquence can appear inarticulate. Masters of the Tao might appear insignificant to a world that equates greatness with wealth and status. Through the movement of the Tao, that which is great is already on the way to becoming small, and vice versa. Avoid taking anything to its fullest unless you deliberately want to cultivate a state of decline. That can be desirable sometimes.
Passage 46, Cultivating Restraint, Humility.
When the ruler emulates the Tao, peace and prosperity prevail.
For the ruler ignorant of the Tao, strife and conflict follow. Wanting what you do not have is a certain cause of suffering, discontent with what you have is also a cause of suffering. Knowing how much is enough leads to contentment.
Commentary: big organizations are usually wealthy and powerful. But wealth is a two-edged sword, since the more one has, the more one worries about someone stealing it. The organization becomes risk-averse, the drive and creativity that led to its rise to power turns to conservatism and avoidance of taking risks. Their power leads them to think they are unassailable, and in their complacency lies great peril.
The wise do not display their wealth, such as it is. What the envious do not see, they will not be tempted to steal. Passage 47, The Secrets of Creation. Deep understanding of the universe comes from the Tao. Know the whole world. Know the laws of nature. No need to go outside. Travel is not necessary. Meditate on the Tao. Know without trekking. See without looking. Achieve without doing.
Commentary: meditate on the Tao for deep intuitive knowledge of nature, society, and the world at large. More understanding can come from a single flash of intuitive insight than might be gained from a year of academic reading.
Travel if you want to, there is much enjoyment to be had. Travel can be a spiritual practice in its own right.
Just know that deep knowledge can be found within by meditating on the Tao. Passage 48, Strategic Non-Action.
Wisdom is not achieved through adding more knowledge, rather by subtracting knowledge to reveal the essence.
Every day, unlearn something
and return to simplicity.
Do less to achieve more.
It is the paradox of the Tao. Do nothing, yet nothing is left undone.
This is strategic non-action. Commentary: unlearn, forget or otherwise rid yourself of the accumulated layers of cultural learning that conceal your essential self and blind you to your true identity. This is the essence of Zen practice, the paring back of personality to reveal your essential self as it exists in the present moment, an energy field of awareness moving through time, accepting the reality of the moment without resistance. Non-action, or wu-wei, produces deeper insights into the nature of reality than knowledge that comes from action.
Such knowledge is situation-specific and is likely to be only relatively true.
Knowledge gained through non-action applies more broadly to the world at large.
Passage 49, Having No Fixed Mind. Having no fixed mind, the wise embrace all. Neutralizing the bad, nourishing the good, keeping an open heart. Trust and kindness, moderates extremes, creating harmony. Commentary, having an open, accepting, non-judgmental mind with a benevolence outlook is a transformative mindset that neutralizes extremes and creates harmony. The benevolence extends to everyone, even the malevolent. Especially the malevolent, since benevolence is the way to neutralize it. Benevolence emulates the Tao, which bestows blessings upon all, even the apparently unworthy. Their negativity is transformed by positivity into a neutral state. Passage 50, The Flame That Burns Bright. Out of a group of 10 people, as they journey through life, 3 are constructive, 3 are destructive, and 3 more are free riders. All 9 react to the world. They only see the physical. But the wise 1 out of 10 sees beyond the physical and aligns with the Tao. Thus, they avoid harm. They travel far yet stay safe. The soldiers do not find them. Criminals do not injure them. Wild animals refrain from attack. They are the 1 out of 10 who has transcended the physical and lives in harmony with the Tao. Commentary, being in harmony with the Tao looks to many like blind luck. The wise use energy coming in from their senses to fund inner growth. They avoid frivolous waste, only talk when there's something to say, and only act when the act is called for. They conserve their resources by absorbing more energy than they expend. Passage 51, The Origins of Creation. Nature is the mother of all. Nourishes all with her virtue. Gives shape to the entire world. and drives the great cycle of life. Nature does not demand respect from those who benefit the most. Therefore, honor the mother of all, and your blessing shall multiply. Guide without interference. Act through non-action. Help but expect no thanks. This is the way of the Tao. Commentary: Nature is the benevolent mother of all, an expression of the Tao in a planetary sense. She is the driving force behind the great cycle that brings forth all life and somehow sustains it. Living in harmony with nature is the key to a harmonious life. Allow others the freedom to be who they are without interference. Let Wu Wei be the guiding principle. Contribute to the greater good, but do not expect to be thanked. If you are thanked, that is a bonus. Few people thank Mother Nature, but she will provide any way. That's the nature of the Tao.
Passage 52, Dwelling at the Center. In the beginning, there was the Big Bang. Nothing existed before that. In the first instant, there was the One. The One has been differentiating ever since.
One became two, two became four, four became eight. Soon there were millions, and billions, and trillions, more. And from the One came the uncountable trillions. If you know the One, you know the Tao, you know the nature of all that follows.
Contemplate this, keep your peace.
Listen more than you speak, no need to rush about, emulate the Tao, go with the flow, yield and prosper. Commentary: The Tao is the great singularity that existed in the first instant of the Big Bang, and which has been diversifying, becoming more differentiated ever since.
Don't be distracted by the complexities of the world.
Keep your eye on the One, the origin of all, and prosperity follows. Becoming enmeshed in the minutiae of everyday life leads to exhaustion to no good effect.
Passage 53, Avoiding Escalation. Avoiding extremes and side paths. I stay on the track through the middle. My challenge is to stay on track and avoid enticing distractions. When shows of wealth are displayed, the duty of everyday living is neglected. Shows of wealth excite greed and envy,
incites bad behavior in others.
This is not the way of the Tao.
Commentary: In evolving social environments, there will always be tension, if not conflict, between opposing ideas. Avoiding escalation of tension and conflict is wise because the ideas that prevail are usually those whose advocates have delivered their case to avoid strong counter-reactions.
Force is met with force, strategy with strategy in a mindset of zero-sum gain. I win, you lose.
Lao Tzu considered that the side that regrets the use of force triumphs.
Passage 54, Envisaging a Better World. Like the giant redwood and ancient oak, what is deeply rooted is not easily torn up. Find the deeply rooted knowledge of the Tao. Let its beneficence flow down the generations. It brings virtue into your life. It nourishes and prospers the family. It nourishes the community prospers. It nourishes the nation prospers. It nourishes the whole universe, the universe prospers. Cultivate the Tao and it will flow through you.
The family, the community, the nation and beyond.
The Tao is the beginning and end of all things.
Commentary: Expand awareness by imagining an ideally functioning world, with fully conscious people living in well-run communities. Over time, this view of the world expands into the outer world and spreads its influence. Lao Tzu envisaged a world of enlightened people being firmly in control of their own destinies.
All are united into a unified, compassionate entity.
The Tao Te Ching is Lao Tzu's attempt to bring about such a world.
Passage 55, Truth in Non-Action. The virtue of the Tao is like a newborn child. The world knows your goodness. Adversaries perceive no threat, see no reason to attack. Predators perceive no threat, and do not risk attack. Even biting insects leave you alone. The body remains young and adaptable. The strength of youth abides. The virtue of the Tao confers great energy. Much can be achieved without becoming exhausted. You know when to rest, when to act. The harmony of the Tao confers long life and happiness. Commentary: Like a newborn child, have no fixed ideas and don't be certain of anything. And like the child, be ever in the now. Notice how the world is evolving. see it moment by moment. Fixed ideas obscure such perceptions. The purest knowledge reaches you when the world is not reacting to you or your conduct. Passage 56, One with the Evolving Universe. Those who know the Tao do not speak. They stay silent, and watch the world unfold. Those who think they know the Tao have much to say, and think they are clever. When one who does not, becomes one who does, you will know him by his silence. Followers of the Tao moderate their desires. Indulge not in anger but cultivate humility. Their body came from dust, and one day shall return. Knowing this is humility. Friends and foes depart, and with them all ideas of good and evil, honor and shame. And as the mind transcends duality and sees connectedness all around, enlightenment dawns, you are home. Commentary, the wise keep their own counsel, the better to learn from the unfolding patterns around them everywhere. Telling the world, you know, is a sure sign that you don't really know. Moderation and simplicity are the keys to enlightenment. Passage 57, Unity of Effort. It is not enough to value justice. One must be seen to be just. When conflict becomes necessary, do the unexpected. Strategic non-action brings all things to pass. The more rules imposed on behavior, the more devious people become. The more capable the military becomes, the more work there is for them to do, the more complicated the world becomes, the more difficult it is to find peace. Therefore, find simplicity. Take no action. People have no reason to be devious. Be peaceful, and people become honest. Simplicity and non-action are the way of the Tao. Commentary, the wise leader is perceived as one who is fair-minded, plays no favorites and does not over-regulate people's daily affairs. Simplicity and strategic non-action are the keys to good leadership.
Passage 58, Spontaneity, not rigidity. Avoid micromanagement, give people what they need, and the freedom to decide, prosperity and happiness results. Harsh regimes create misery, it has always been so.
Obvious, but not to the tyrant. Tyranny ruins everything. The wise leader is perceptive, and not judgmental, assertive, and not aggressive. Direct, but not insulting. Sets a good example, but with much humility.
Commentary, groups with strict rules usually become dysfunctional because unreasonable force offends human nature.
People grow resentful and find ways to subvert the rules.
Management reacts in the only way it knows how, by applying more pressure. So, people react more strongly, and a negative cycle of oppressive authority and subversive undermining of that authority develops. High-functioning groups on have inner cohesion due to strong mutual interdependence.
Passage 59, Knowing How Much is Enough.
Strategic non-action. In your worldly affairs,
prosperity will grow. In the space thus created, is freedom to think and act. A precious gift to all. When teaching, it is difficult to stay silent. When you know the answer, if you tell them, they will soon forget. Let them work it out themselves, and they will remember. Strategic non-action takes time to master. A useful skill for any leader.
Commentary, strategic non-action allows people to learn their life lessons in their own sweet time in ways they will remember.
It is tempting to give the ones we love the answers to save them time and trouble.
But this is long-term counterproductive if it makes the lesson too easy and therefore forgettable. People don't value the lesson like they would if they worked hard on their own account. Passage 60, Like Cooking a Small Fish.
Leading an organization is like cooking a small fish. Don't prod the fish too much, or it will fall apart in the pan. Practice strategic non-action, and people will not be resentful, nor will they react badly. The organization will thrive. It is there in the sweet spot, between passive and aggressive, that you will find the Tao, helping all towards fulfillment.
Commentary, the wise leader maintains a light touch in much the same way as a cook avoids too much prodding when cooking something delicate. In organizations, A micromanaging leader inhibits the creativity and autonomy of the team.
If there is no apparent solution to a problem, it is best to simply let it be and allow nature to evolve a solution.
In this culture of simplicity and non-interference, people engaging in subterfuge to maintain their cover and their strategies tend to be rendered ineffective.
Passage 61, Strength in Diversity. A nation is like a lake. It collects a spectrum of people, as a lake collects its tributary waters. It is the space for people to live together. Open and calm, it receives those who come. When a group should arrive and says, "Let us in," the great country brings them into the fold, transforming the whole into something new. This diverse nation has a hybrid strength, therefore, to yield is to conquer. To conquer, one must yield. This is win-win. Commentary: It is a well-established principle in genetics that inbreeding weakens a species, while outbreeding strengthens it. A great nation derives much of its physical and intellectual strength from the integrated hybrid diversity of its people. That nation acts like a reservoir of human potential, collecting people and folding them into the cultural mix. Wise leaders understand that there is strength in diversity and actively encourage the integration of the newcomers into society. Passage 62, The group becomes a team. All things to all people. The Tao is the universal source. Yet most have not heard that it is the rising tide that floats all boats alike. The rowboat and the ocean liner. All lifted with ease as one. Empowering good people. Sustaining the bad alike. It makes the bad person good. And the good person better. Therefore, the wise cultivate the Tao. You have nothing to lose. Everything to gain. Commentary, the enlightened leader makes it their business to help everyone towards fulfillment and higher attainment, not just those that seem somehow worthy of preferment. Passage 63, Being non-confrontational. Strategic non-action is the refuge of the wise. Results come without doing. When you allow events to unfold without interference, the outcome might not be what you imagined, but it will be in harmony with the Tao. Therefore, reduce what is full. Augment what is empty. Bring it to the middle, where the Tao is strongest. Then the difficult thing becomes easy. The complicated becomes simple. It is from this place of moderation that all things originate. Find this place and dwell there. Commentary, being like a baby is the essence of the Tao. They are in touch with their primal nature that existed before society paved over it with cultural learning. Because the young are clear embodiments of the Tao, the world does not harm them. Neither do the young struggle for wealth and power.
Passage 64, A river flowing around boulders.
The oak seedling is uprooted with finger and thumb. A century later, a mighty tree, how difficult then?
Hard, unyielding things are prone to breaking, because they do not bend. Like the seedling, the beginning is easily influenced, they are small and simple and adaptable. Later, the winter storm brings down the ancient oak, its strength becomes its weakness, because it does not bend. Emulate the Tao and be like the seedling, not the old tree.
How many people in their old age are unyielding? To live long, remain flexible, resist not the flow of life. Position your mind at the beginning. The journey of 1,000 miles, begins with a single step.
Commentary, apply your efforts to the weakest area.
When the weakness absorbs the effort, the weakness moves to another location.
Act like a river finding its way through a valley of stones.
When the water encounters a stone, it flows around it and continues unhindered.
Passage 65, Avoid Machiavellian strategies.
In ancient times and cultures past, people were not told of the Tao. They could not be trusted. Seeking strategies for power.
The Tao is simple and unremarkable. Slow, incremental, evolutionary.
No pomp and ceremony, no fanfare. Though being the mother of all things. Simple, Tao-inspired leadership. Confers great blessings to all. As we return to oneness.
Commentary, deceptively simple in appearance. Knowledge of the Tao is nonetheless powerful, just like reading this book. In the hands of a Machiavellian, such knowledge can be perverted, turned to nefarious purpose. But the mighty Tao seems ordinary, easily overlooked. Its action is so slow that long periods pass with little movement, yet move it does, and in so doing brings all physical forms into existence.
It is just too slow for most people to grasp.
The wise leader emulates the Tao and behaves with simple benevolence and modesty.
Passage 66, Humility. The ocean is a great collector of every river and stream. So too the best of leaders are a servant, not a master. They create the environment where people thrive in their work. When done, the people say, "We did it ourselves." This humble leader is barely even noticed, much less despised. They earn the respect of all those who follow.
Commentary: wise leaders discern people's talent and has them doing what they do best, a round peg in a round hole.
They arrange things so that people can work without micromanagement.
Operating with strategic non-action, such leaders create high-performing teams who get the job done.
And when the work is done, the team gets the credit.
They think it was all their own work, not recognizing the work the leader did to create the right conditions for them to do the work.
But the leader is content with this, knowing it is how to get the best from people.
Passage 67, Compassion. The virtue that flows through the Tao and into the world is boundless. Its forms too numerous to count. Those of us with eyes to see, know its multitude of blessings. Three in particular, given by the Tao. First is mercy, from this comes courage. Second is frugality, from this comes generosity. Third is humility, from this comes leadership. But many today shun mercy, and only pretend to be brave. They disparage frugality, and pretend to be generous. Humility is for the weak, they seek always to be first. This thinking leads to downfall. Mercy, frugality and humility, these things make you strong. Commentary: wise leaders are compassionate, modest and not boastful. It is as true today as it was in Lao Tzu's time. Compassion has a deeply transformative effect on a person's mind and on those they meet. Passage 68, The Virtue of Restraint. A good soldier fights only when necessary. When he does fight, he is cool and calm. As the victor, he does not gloat. As the vanquished, he is not vengeful. This soldier has cultivated the virtue of restraint since ancient times. This is unity with heaven. Commentary: Wu Wei can be interpreted as restraint under provocation. Acting rashly in heated situations puts you into the same class as the provocateur, even though you might think you were justified in your actions. It always takes two to make a fight. The wise see no advantage in engaging in battle except as last resort. Passage 69, Not Initiating. The restraint of the good soldier extends to not making the first move. Rather, he waits for his opponent to act. Strategic non-action might yet avoid the fight. Retreat rather than advance might likewise avoid. The opponent sees your strength and decides not to fight. The good soldier never underestimates his opponent. That can lead to catastrophe. When fighting is unavoidable, be the righteous underdog. Commentary: Wu Wei can be interpreted as not making the first move. By waiting, you force the other to make the first move. Either that or to disengage, and that concludes the matter. When forced to fight, be the ferocious underdog who seeks only an equitable outcome.
Passage 70, Embodying the Tao. My words are so simple yet so hard to follow. The people do not understand.
My words come from the source, their origins are not recognized.
I go about the world humbly, there is no pretense or grandeur.
Rare individuals recognize me, and regard me with reverence.
To all others, I am nobody. Commentary: The Tao is the essence of simplicity.
Discussion about the Tao is bound to be simple and direct.
Yet its simplicity disguises the depth.
The great majority in the world, with rare exceptions, see nothing remarkable in the Tao or in those persons who embody the Tao. The wise disguise their virtue with simple humility. The world does not recognize their virtue and wisdom. No honor is afforded them. But this is good, since it allows the wise to operate unhindered without drawing attention to themselves. Thus, they can avoid unwanted attention.
Passage 71, The Disease. When you know that you do not know, that is wisdom. Not knowing that you do not know is ignorance. Being proudly ignorant is called the disease. Wisdom comes when now you understand that there is much that you do not know and will perhaps never know. It is all right to not know. But it is not all right to claim to know and yet do not.
Commentary: there is so much knowledge in the world that no one person can possibly possess it all, or even come close.
Knowing that there is much you do not know is wisdom.
But the person who insists they know everything worth knowing when they just know a lot about one aspect of the total, that person is guilty of prideful ignorance. Lao Tzu considered this a particularly unfortunate failing. The remedy is to remember that no matter how much you know, there is always so much more that you do not know. So vast is the store of knowledge accumulated by humanity over the centuries. With this awareness, you can be humble about your learning and remain open to new information from the evolving world. Passage 72, respecting above and below.
Lack of respect leads to conflict. Reverence leads to peace. Respect people in their homes by not invading their privacy. Respect people at work by letting them do their work. Show them respect, and they will not tire of you. The wise do not display their virtue. They keep it hidden, where it will not be misunderstood. The sage has self-respect. They appear humble in the eyes of the world.
Commentary: wise leaders treat everyone with respect.
They do not kiss up and kick down, treating those of higher status with deference and those of lower status with contempt.
At work, respect is giving credit where credit it is due.
At home, it is minding one's own business to live and let live.
Respect for self implies being humble in one's achievements, not needing the approval of others.
Passage 73, the patterns of nature. The brave but intemperate man kills or gets killed. The brave but temperate man avoids killing. In the eyes of society and their fellows, which of these two men is superior? Being temperate follows the Tao, that which causes all events, each in their sequence. It is not passionate, it is not hasty, still it fulfills, accomplishes all, with effortless grace. There is no better model. Commentary: the man of action who serves the collective tribal mind is praised as a patriot. The same man, having acquired the virtue of temperateness, is likewise a patriot, but less visibly so. It is difficult to see the virtuous since the Tao is always modest. The Tao's actions are measured and mild, yet somehow all things are accomplished by means so subtle that most people do not notice, much less care. Passage 74, recognizing the beginning. When a man is unafraid to die, why threaten him with death? When a man is afraid to die, then men will obey the law. When to break it means death. Ruling with fear is self-defeating before long. Rule with subtle influence. Make them want to do what you want them to do. That is true leadership. Commentary: coercing people into obedience might work for a short time, but not for long. Much better to use subtle influence to get people to want to do what it is you want them to do. Then they think it was their idea. Then it is difficult to stop them from doing what you want them to do, not that you would try. The best time to influence events is at the beginning, before they acquire momentum. Passage 75, the doomed leader. The punitive leader is a tyrant who oppresses suffering people with crippling taxes and death for dissent. The children go to bed hungry so the leader can live in luxury. Abused people lose interest in living. Death seems preferable to life. The wise leader employs subtle influence to guide people in the direction that is in their best interest to go. When they get there, they are barely aware of the wise ruler's influence. Commentary: oppressive regimes follow a predictable trajectory. When more and more force is needed to ensure compliance, people lose interest in living. Death is preferable to life for the tyrant's miserable subjects. Their regime is doomed from the start. It is arrogance that blinds them to this reality. Better to create the right conditions at the beginning and using subtle influence, guide people in the direction you want them to go, which is also the direction that is best for them.
Passage 76, responding to the world. Living things are flexible. responsive to life. Dead things are rigid, unresponsive, uncompromising. Seek then the living. Emulate its flexibility. Adapt to change and prosper. Choose this over rigidity and death.
Commentary: being alive in the world calls for continuing adaptability and compromise.
It requires the willingness to change and move with the times. Resistance to change in the long term is futile. It will always break you in the end. Having an inflexible, stubborn attitude puts a person into the category of the dead and dying. They resist the movement of the Tao, but in time, the accumulated forces of change become too great.
In one's daily affairs, emulate the flexibility of the living and not the inflexibility of the dying. In the great cycle being, this puts you on the rising part of the curve before it reaches its peak of maturity and begins to decline. Adapting to change and embracing the new is therefore the key to longevity. Perceive the subtle ways of the world and respond in ways that promote personal growth. Passage 77, Channeling the Tao.
The Tao in nature reduces the great, increases the small, brings all to the middle. But the society of people increases the already wealthy and reduces the already poor. But the wise use the Tao to bring balance to society.
Commentary: nature has a self-leveling way that reduces what has grown excessive and increases what has too little to sustain itself, bringing all towards the middle. Yet in society, it is common to see those who have much receiving even more, and those with too little receiving less. But the same moderating influence observed in nature comes into effect in the social sphere to curb that which is excessive and give sustenance to those in need.
Understanding this self-leveling tendency in nature, the wise use it to bring benefit to the world. They keep their expectations low. They do not to seek status and acclaim for their good deeds.
They stay inconspicuous and perform their work unhindered. Passage 78, Accepting Responsibility.
Hardness is overcome by softness.
Flowing water turns the boulder into sand. One big rock becomes a million smaller rocks.
The movement of the Tao seems very slow. There must be a faster way, people think. But the wise know better. They take the hard problems and let time turn them into solutions. Commentary: the wise emulate the qualities of water. Soft and accommodating, yet able to wear down the hardest of substances in time with the force of its ceaseless flow.
With no edge and no form, the soft water wears down the hard river stones. By accepting responsibility, the wise occupy the center of the organization.
Their influence extends outwards from the center.
But the movement of the Tao is slow, intolerably slow for those who lack the patience for the Tao to resolve problems. In the spirit of Wu Wei, waiting patiently will often turn problems into harmonious solutions.
Passage 79, Being Magnanimous. When you have power, exercise it gently, do not take advantage and create resentment. Instead, create goodwill with selfless generosity. Commentary: when you are in a position of power, or you hold the advantage in the relationship, refrain from taking advantage simply because you can get away with it. The resentment thus created comes back to trouble you. Behaving generously towards the other creates the goodwill upon which a productive relationship of trust may be built. Occasionally, people will take advantage of your generosity and someone absconds with more than their share. Resign yourself to having learned a valuable lesson about who you can trust and bear this in mind when entering into future arrangements, contractual or otherwise. Passage 80, Promoting Independence. It is natural for people to live in tightly knit communities. City life is a two-edged sword. Who needs an automobile when it is easier to walk? No need to brandish weapons. When neighbors live in peace, their children are happy. Their food is wholesome. Their clothes well made. Their homes are secure. The occasional annoyance passes unheeded. Life is long. Life is good. Commentary: Lao Tzu considered the ideal social unit to be one where every member is given the means to reach their potential in whichever direction that takes them. There is healthcare, education, recreation, everything needed for a fulfilling life and the pursuit of happiness. People value their life, so they value the life-enhancing pursuits that they know is the way to find themselves, develop a strong sense of purpose and ultimately reach their full potential. When a person feels strong and independent, they will work hard, maintain good relationships and remain loyal to the group. Passage 81, Evolving with the Tao. Sincerity needs to be expressed simply. Embellished words are seldom sincere. Good conscience needs no defense. Bad conscience needs defending. Great learning hinders the Tao. To know the Tao, unlearn. Engage not in sophistry. Give in order to receive. Great truth is simple. Strive for simplicity. And know the Tao. Commentary, if something is true and good, it needs no embellishment. Simplicity speaks eloquently of goodness. People with nothing to hide should avoid a defensive posture. Being relaxed and open speaks louder than defensive words or posture. The guilty are naturally defensive. Their guilty demeanor informs on them. Knowing the Tao requires the unlearning of worldly knowledge. It is baggage that slows you down. The greater the truth, the more simply it can be expressed, therefore strive for simplicity. The simpler your truth, the closer to the Tao you approach. And this concludes the 81 passages of the Tao Te Ching. Thanks for listening. Go in peace.